And if you weren't here, we totally understand because it was a suddenly service. And if you didn't know about it, you need to get on our e-blast. And what that is if you'll sign up in the lobby to get a notification of suddenly services, then we'll email you the schedule of what the Holy Ghost is going to do. You know, he told us he would show us things to come. And so Friday night, we just came together and had a praise and prayer service. And it was so much fun, I hardly wanted it to end. But I'm so glad. I think we've just stepped back into the overflow of what was happening Friday night. Amen. But I wanted Wendy, she got a really cool text from, who was it from? From Rita, our children's director, concerning what happened in the children. Now, can I set it up?
Yeah.
We were up here singing, and maybe the third front of the auditorium was filled, but I looked in the back there, and there were the children. You know, 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8, with their hands raised and jumping around and praising God. And I thought, that's too good to miss. So I brought them up on the platform, and then they led us in praise and in worship and in thanksgiving. And then they just stayed in here. But when they left the auditorium and we continued, they thought they were going to maybe watch a movie or do something else. But what was continued in here kept going in the back room. And I wanted Wendy to make you aware of that.
In fact, the children are back there right now. Yeah. Woo. Yay. Aw. So awesome. Was it Pastor Paul that got up and talked about, did you just say that about revival?
Talking about when you see revival, when you see the Spirit of God on the
children. Yeah. Yes. Well, this is so awesome. Miss Rita sent me this text. Rita, I hope it's okay if I read it. And, you know, I'm learning really well on how to do all this text lingo stuff. So I might get a word wrong here and there. But she said, "Hi, I wanted to share about last night. Worship was so amazing. The kids loved it so much that they all asked if they could go back, if we could go back often. Praise God. When we got back to the Super Kids room, I did some teaching and opened the altars for the kids to pray on subjects we discussed. A lot of kids went and prayed. Some prayed in their seats. I have seen that in Super Kids, but the power of the Holy Spirit was so strong that many of them were crying. Now, I have never seen this in the children's church. It was so beautiful. I got on my knees and cried. I happened to be by one of the children in the group, and I didn't even know she was crying until we looked at each other after a few minutes. I wanted to make sure she was okay, so I asked if she needed prayer for anything. She said yes. I thought she may be sad about something, and I asked what she wanted. She said she'd like prayer, what she would like prayer for. She said she wanted prayer for the Holy Spirit to give her more power to lead, more power to be faithful, more power to be disciplined.
I'll take that.
Wow. More power
to change
the world. More power to shake hell for the kingdom of God. Woo! Isn't that awesome?
Hallelujah!
Man, whew. She was sobbing while she was telling me this. Now, usually, if the kiddos go to pray, they'll be at the altars for a few minutes, and things will start to get antsy, little smiley face. But we just kept playing music for a while. I love that, how in the back there with the kids, they'd follow the Holy Spirit, too. They just didn't get on with, okay, well, next on our agenda here, but they were following the Holy Spirit and watching the Holy Spirit move in the kids. So we just kept playing music for a while, and the kiddos didn't want to get up. They just stayed kneeling and praying. And the kiddos were in their seats praying or just quiet. It was totally sovereign, strong presence of God. Then the leaders went and prayed for a few kiddos that still needed prayer. Revival! Praise God. He's doing something in their hearts.
What was it? More, I want to see those prayer requests again. More power to be faithful, more power to be disciplined, more power to shake hell for the kingdom of God. out of the mouths of babes and infants. Hallelujah. What was it?
To lead, more power to be disciplined, more power to change the world and shake hell for the kingdom of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, we better do this before we go too much further in the service. We have kids, VBS, Vacation Bible School, coming up in just a few weeks. I wonder what's going to happen during that.
That's going to be awesome.
I wonder if we're in the middle of suddenlies and immediatelies that have been prophesied for thousands of years. And I wonder if it would start with the children first and then lead us right into it. Hallelujah. But before we go any further, Jason, could we make the people aware of what's coming up in Vacation Bible School by way of a video? Watch this, if you will.
Let's give him the praise. The great things he has done. Amen. And the great things he's about to do in our kids' lives. We worship you. Praise you, Father.
Hallelujah.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, we worship you. We magnify you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, we glorify you. Come on, let's lift our hands and just give him the praise right now. Hallelujah, Jesus. We glorify you, Lord. We magnify you, Jesus. You're worthy of all praise. You're worthy of all glory and honor. Hallelujah.
We stand and lift up.
Thank you. just lift up our voices and just magnify you. I'm so glad the kids came down front. We didn't ask them to do this. They just came down front because they wanted to worship. Let's all lift up our hands again. Let's just worship in the Holy Ghost here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In this congregation, we lift our voice. Worship you, Lord Most High. Glorify your name. Seems to be an anointing on this song. I want us to start it out the cow again. for them. Are standing up here, but everybody knows this. Help me sing this. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me.
Jesus loves me.
that you, the Father God, you are love. You're the beginning and you're the end. You're the Alpha, you're the Omega. You're everything in between. More than anything else, you are love. And we thank you for that love that took the form of the Lord Jesus Christ, that we might have life and healing and restoration and deliverance from any form of bondage, and actually deliverance from every form of strife. For where the Spirit of the Lord is, and where the Spirit is Lord, there is liberty and freedom. And I pray for the person on my right and on my left right now, my family, my church family right now. And I want you to lift up your voice and pray ye one for another, that you may be healed and that you may be strengthened right now. Just take 1 minute. Don't drop hands. Strengthen the one by whom you stand. Strengthen them right now with the love of God, with peace, with the anointing, with the anointing of increase. Father, thank you. That there's no lack in any home on this Father's Day. That you will turn the hearts of the Father to the children and the children to the fathers. On Father's Day, may we know you as Father God, you who are love, in a brand new way. And I pray fervently for every person right now in this room and all whose hands are joined, that we remind ourselves inseparably, we are joined to you. And we thank you. And now drop hands and lift them one more time and thank your Father that he loved you and he loves you. And we thank you, Father. Hallelujah. 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 You can shout if you want to. I'm getting ready to take a turn, so we might as well shout one more time. Please be seated. I want my wife Wendy to come up and maybe just share whatever is on your heart.
Hallelujah. First of all, I want to say happy Father's Day to all the dads in the room. But can we just have all the fathers stand up so we can just honor you this morning? Wow. I want to share a story with you. I was talking to the Lord this morning about what to share regarding fathers. And of course, there's so many different things. But this story, when I was in my, just a young adult, probably about 20, 21, our family, we used to have a Hobie Cat, you know, a 16-foot sailboat. Do you guys know what a Hobie Cat is? It's got the, like the kind of trampoline on it, and then two pontoons. And so we used to do that every summer for vacation. And so we went out this one summer. We always went to Mission Bay, which is on the bay, which is real safe. And we're really used to it. And the whole family, we all sailed. Well, this particular time, it was my mom and dad, and I think it was my younger brother, Jared, that was with us, and myself. And we went out. We decided to go out on the ocean this time because just be fun, and then we could go over by the beach and kind of see some other areas that we hadn't ventured out to see. So my dad was sailing the little boat, and we're all on there, and it was a beautiful day, and it just looked like a great time to go and do that. And then as the afternoon came about, the weather changed a little bit, and what happened was the wind changed. And if you know about a Hobie Cat, you know there's no little motor on there, and you're really relying on the wind, because that, you know, has a mainsail and a jib sail, and typically you just have to turn the boat in the direction of the wind so that you can pick up the wind to get where you want to go. But if you don't have a wind, then you don't go. So this particular day, we were out there in the ocean. It's starting to look like it's about to get dark, and the wind changed, and clouds are kind of rolling in and stuff. And so now we're out in the ocean, and the waves are starting to get bigger out in the ocean. And And I remember for a moment thinking, because I used to sail that thing all the time. I mean, I take it out by myself. I used to, me and my girlfriend used to take it out and, you know how you can fly the hull? We used to tip it over on purpose so we could have boys help us get it back over after us.
I didn't know this, but praise the Lord.
It's truth serum up here. But anyway, so I'm well aware of how this all works with the wind and the sails and stuff. And so you can't just tighten the sail if the wind's going the wrong direction. And the way to get back into the safe area, you have to go through this little channel to get in there. But the wind is coming, the wind is going the same direction. So to get through that channel, we're going straight into the wind. And what you do, if you go straight into the wind, then you stop. You can't go in. And also the ocean is going like this. So it was kind of scary. And I remember at this one moment, it was really one of those aha moments in my life. I remember looking at my dad, and he was the one that was in charge. And I thought, okay, I'm going to turn around and see what his face looks like, and then I'll know, you know, how this really is. And so I turned around and looked at Dad, and he was as calm and as confident as if there was never an issue. Because really, you know, you don't have your cell phones with you because there's no, you're wet and all that. And so we could have just been out there at the sea and all of that. But Dad had such a calm about him. And I was thinking about that so many times in my life. I've thought about that when how our children look to us. And fathers, do you realize how much your children are looking to you? They look to you, that they watch how you worship God. They watch how you study the Bible, how you come to church, how you treat your wife, how you look at your wife, or how you don't look at your wife, or, you know, your children are, they're watching so much. And some of you have grown children, some of you still have little children, but I just want to encourage you to remember that impact. You have such an impact on your children, and they're watching you. You know, the way that you are, your sons will follow the example that you set. And the way that you treat your wife, your daughters will expect that from their husband when they grow up and get married. And so it's so important to recognize that. And the thing is, God loves the family so much. And He put such an emphasis. The Bible talks about our seed all the time. And so, you know, some of you have even grandchildren, and still that's applicable. Your seed is so valuable, and you are anointed as a father. And so even, you know, we've all made our mistakes in parenting and things, but if you can remember that today, that you're anointed to be the head of your household, to be the father to your children, you're anointed to speak and to decree over your family. And you're anointed to lead your family.
Yeah.
And you know, God talks about Abraham, how much he loved Abraham and how he chose him because God knew that he could trust him to teach the word to his children and that they would pass it on to their descendants and to their descendants. And look how blessed Abraham was. So I just want to encourage you, take that as an encouragement today. Even from today and this day forward, you are anointed to be a father. You're anointed to be a grandfather. And some of you, I have so loved watching in the church how some of you may not have children or young people, young men or women around you, but you you men in the church have been fatherly and as spiritual fathers and even as natural fathers to young men in the church and helped so much. And we need that so much, and I love to see how you do that. And it's good to even raise up the standard even more for you men out there. Show that there's a lot of kids that don't have a father in their home, and so you can be that in their lives in the church. Amen. So I just wanted to encourage you in that today and tell you have a happy Father's Day. And honey, happy Father's Day. I'm so blessed to just in seeing, you know, with our children, I'm so blessed to see how David's example to our kids, how they how he's so honorable, so loving and kind to them, such a great example. You know how things happen even in life, how your kids watch, even when rough things happen, and your kids are watching, and they see how you respond. And you, at the time, if it's rough for you, you're not thinking about what my response is. But and then a lot of times what happens is your kids grow up and respond the same way in life. And so I'm so blessed at the example that you are to our kids. And an awesome husband as well.
Thank you. I have to give her a hand for that. Not for the part of... God bless you. I want us to prepare to receive our tithes and offerings this morning. Now, don't move too much right now, because I totally put my son on the spot this morning. And I said, you know what? I think you're supposed to receive. Just give up, get up and give a scripture. Tell a story if you want to. Just give the people an opportunity to worship the Lord with their tithe. And in connection with what Wendy just said to you, you're looking at a blessed man. Hallelujah. And it's not only obviously because of my wife, but because of my kids. And this one in particular. Hallelujah. Love them all. And each one have their particular gifts and graces and anointings. But the Holy Ghost knew what he was doing when he said, you have to name this one Caleb. Hallelujah. And so I'm putting you on the spot, son. And as you come, the people are with you. Hallelujah. Hey, son, let me just have mom just mentioned there a minute, there's an anointing to be a father. Did you get that part? There's an anointing to be a grandfather?
Yes. It's going to be just a while. Go ahead. Well, my mom pretty much covered the whole Father's Day speech already. I did want to, you know, thank my dad personally for how great a dad you've been to me all my life. And I do have a funny story, actually.
Please don't tell it.
It's a great one. You know, all through my life, my dad's always gone all out for, you know, us, you know, when it comes to vacation and stuff like that. And one year in particular, years ago, I was probably about 11 or so, my dad took me to New York City, which I was super excited about. And, you know, we got to go in the city. It was a big change. You know, we were in Manhattan, right?
Yeah.
We stayed there. And and so, you know, we went to all the sites and all that. And one in particular, we went to see where the, you know, the Twin Towers fell apart and all that. And so I remember we were heading to the subway after that. And so, you know, my dad's a really fast walker, and I'm more of the slow type. And I remember my dad thinking that I'm a few feet behind him, that, you know, I'm just kind of walking. And I think I saw like a hot dog stand or a churro stand that I was attracted to. So I kind of lost, you know, my dad. So, you know, I was trying to keep up. And so we're walking. And so my dad gets in the subway, and I'm about to walk to the subway. But as it happens, the doors slowly start closing. So my dad runs and, you know, tries to keep the doors open there like this, and I'm just kind of standing there like, like, what's gonna happen? I'm in New York City. And so my dad's like, and so luckily, you know, my dad's stubborn enough to try to keep the doors open, but, you know, you had to, you can't just force them, they're pretty shut, But so luckily the doors, you know, came open again, and you know, we didn't get separated, thank God. That would have been a pretty scary moment. But yeah, I just thought of that story and, you know, how great my dad is for paying attention that the doors were closing and not just thinking like, well there we go. My son's outside the subway, so. Oh yeah, and we just told my mom that story about a year ago. So,
well, when we got home, I said, you know what, we don't need to share that part with mom about being separated there just for a little bit on the subway. There'll come a day for that. It's just not now.
It was fun. We had a blast. But even throughout the years too, you know, I'm receiving the tithes and offerings, and growing up, my parents, especially my dad, not just hearing him preach from the pulpit, but you know, as growing up, helping me out, you know, say I'd get $10, you know, he'd be like, well, now you have a dollar to put in the tithe, you know, so God could bless you even more. And just doing that, forming that habit of doing that and honoring God with the tithe, you know, that's his. You know, I've seen amazing things happen in my life just because, you know, God likes to do that stuff. Amen.
Amen.
So I wanted to read a quick scripture to you. It's in Psalm 35:27. I'm sure you guys know it. But it says, let them shout for joy and be glad.
Woo!
You guys glad? That favor my righteous cause. Ye let them say continually, let the Lord be magnified, which hath pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. So I decided to ask my phone Siri what, you know, the exact definition of what pleasure was. And I found, and it says, an activity that affords enjoyment, something or someone that provides a source of happiness. And what's so cool is that, you know, God is such a good God, and that's all he is good. You know, unfortunately, a lot of Christians these days are hesitant to give their tithe because they think of God as like, you know, well, God loves me, he's a good big God, but, you know, many people kind of view him as a big guy on the throne, just kind of serious, you know, kind of tolerating us, you know, and saying, pay me my tithe, you know. Which isn't the case at all. You know, he loves to prosper us, he loves to bless us.
Yes.
And he, you know, he gets excited, he gets enjoyment from that. And so in Luke chapter 11, verse 11, I thought this was pretty cool, especially since it's Father's Day. It says, if a son asks for bread from any father among you, will he give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will he give him a serpent instead of a fish? I hope not. Or if he asks for an egg, will he offer him a scorpion? If you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? And that goes with gifts for the same thing. I always think about my dad too. Year after year, you know, when we go on our family or annual family vacation, it's kind of funny. Months before in advance, we'll get together, have like a family meeting. He'll ask, you know, what we want to do, and so we'll kind of tell him. And so then, you know, as time goes on, you know, as weeks go by, you know, I'll see dad on the computer researching, talking to travel agents. We have like, I can't even count how many vacation books we have just along the shelves year after year because my dad just gets excited, not only because he gets to go and relax, but he enjoys seeing us have, you know, a good time as well, yes, enjoying our lives,
yeah,
you know. And so I was thinking, you know, my dad loves doing that, you know, for us, you know, and God's the exact same way, except bigger, amen, and greater, amen. So I want you guys to be expectant. You know, as you sow your seed, have your seed ready. God's going to do some crazy, ridiculous, stupid miracles in your lives. Amen.
Yeah.
Chang, chang, chang. Amen. So we're going to pray. Do you guys have your seed ready? All right. Father God, we love you so much. We praise you. We thank you for the great promises that you've given us. And Father God, as we sow our seed today, we expect seeding abundantly above all that we could ask or think. We praise you for it, Lord. We receive it, and we thank you for taking pleasure in our prosperity. We expect great things from you in this service and in the days to come. Thank you, Father. We love you so much. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. I've asked Brother Rutledge, But there's more than one Brother Rutledge. Brother Rutledge Sr., Brother Rutledge Jr., and I called, you're the junior, Jonathan, but I called them yesterday and I said, you know, they've been here with us for a couple of weeks and we've so enjoyed the worship and the ministry. And I really wish you'd let him know how much you appreciate. They're leaving this week to head back to Canada. But brother, we're here, and you just follow the leading of the Lord, and that's all I'm going to say. Amen. But we so enjoyed having his ministry and his anointing and the words that he has spoken to us. But I was thinking yesterday, I thought, you know, wouldn't it be fun?